2 years ago, I made a video on cracking product case interviews, and thanks to your feedback, I'm back with an updated version for 2023. If you are a data scientist preparing for a job interview, chances are you will face a product case interview. Product case questions are open-ended, which means many times there's no right or wrong answer, and you will need to cultivate skills like problem solving and critical thinking on your own. These interviews are designed to evaluate your product sense and business acumen, and they can be intimidating even for the most experienced candidates. But fear not, in this video, I will show you how to approach product case interviews with confidence and give yourself the best chance of success. We'll start by looking at what a product case interview is and why it's important. Then we'll explore a data-driven approach to product case interviews, which involves understanding different categories of questions and prioritizing which ones to focus on. I've analyzed over 360 interview questions from 46 companies to identify 7 different categories of product case interview questions. By understanding these categories, you can prepare more effectively for the interview. You'll be able to prioritize which questions to focus on and get a better understanding of the types of problems you'll be asked to solve. Before we get started, I have a product case interview cheat sheet that you can download for free. It covers all the main components we are going to talk about today, plus some additional ones. Just check out the link in the description below to grab your copy. So if you're ready to tackle product case interviews with confidence, let's dive in and get started. A product case interview goes by many names, such as business case, business acumen, product interpretation, or metric interview. Different companies have different names for the same type of interview. Essentially, in a product case interview, you are typically given a business scenario and asked to discuss the approach to solving a problem and make suggestions. The majority of questions involve a company's products or features. Here are some example questions you might encounter. What are the pros and cons of using daily active users as a success metric? How would you investigate a negative metric shift in time spent on the app? How would you design an experiment to test a new feature? If an A/B test shows that the desired metric, such as click-through rate, is going up, while another metric, such as clicks, is decreasing, how would you go about making a launch decision? These types of questions are often asked in technical phone and on-site interviews to evaluate if the candidate has strong business acumen and A/B testing knowledge to do the job well. For product data scientists specifically, at least one round of on-site interviews focuses on case questions. So now you know what a product case interview is, how can you prepare for it? There's where a data-driven approach comes in handy. By looking at different categories of product case interview questions, you can prioritize which questions to focus on and understand what to practice to answer them effectively. So what exactly is a data-driven approach? Well, it's an approach we can take to crack different types of data science interviews successfully. The idea is that by looking at real interview questions, we can understand the distribution of interview questions so you know what to expect when discussing product case questions with potential employers. We can also cover the common types of problems in the least amount of time. For this video, I analyzed over 360 interview questions from 46 different companies, including Uber, DoorDash, Lyft, and Amazon, just to name a few. And guess what? I found 7 common categories of product case interview questions. They are measure success, A/B testing, diagnose a problem, product specific, improve a product, strategic thinking, and estimation. To give you a better idea of these categories, I've even created a pie chart to show you the breakdown of interview questions by category. By understanding these categories of practicing problems for each one, you'll be much better prepared for your next product case interview. So are you ready to dive in and learn more? Let's do this. In a product case interview, you may come across questions that ask you to measure the success of a product or feature. Let's call this type of question measure success. It's a common type of question that accounts for about 23% of interview questions. So how do you measure the success of a product or feature? One way is to examine metrics such as user engagement, conversion rates, and retention. These metrics can help you understand which features are resonating with users and driving business outcomes. For example, let's say you're asked how you would measure the success of YouTube's story feature. What metrics would you look at to see if it's doing well? Another version of the major success question is about products that haven't been launched yet. In this case, you can identify metrics that may be useful for evaluating the potential impact of a new product. For instance, if Uber is planning to launch a referral program for riders, what metrics would you use to measure its success? Finally, it's important to consider the pros and cons of different metrics when measuring success. While conversion rates can be a useful metric for evaluating the impact of a specific feature, they may not capture the full picture of user engagement and satisfaction. You may need to use a combination of metrics to get a better understanding of overall product success. By using the right metrics, you can gain valuable insights into the effectiveness of different features and products and make informed decisions about future product development. Okay, let's move on. The second most common type of question is about A/B testing. Basically, this type of question asks you to design an experiment and make decisions based on the results. There are two ways this type of question can be presented to you. First, you may be given an idea and asked to design an experiment to test it. In this case, you need to think critically about the different components involved in designing a test and come up with a design to address potential issues. Alternatively, you may be asked to come up with an idea first before designing an experiment to test it. This can be a bit more challenging, but it also gives you a chance to be creative and come up with something practical and useful. Once you have proposed your idea, you will need to design an experiment that effectively tests its viability and potential for success. Regardless of the scenario, it's important to analyze the results of the experiment and make informed decisions based on the data available to you. This can involve looking at driver metrics, guardrail metrics, and cost to determine whether the proposed change or idea is effective or not. Here are some simple questions. How would you set up an experiment to test a new feature in Quora? If engagement decreased in one segment but increased in others, how would you decide whether or not to launch a feature change? What changes would you make to TikTok app? How would you test if the proposed change is effective or not? Another type of question you might get in a product case interview is all about problem solving and figuring out what's causing an issue. This is called the Diagnose A Problem question. It's all about investigating the underlying factors that could be causing the problem. So how do you tackle it? Well, it's important to remember that there could be multiple reasons for a problem. So having a structured approach that prioritizes investigation steps is key. You need to know what to look at first and what to look at later. Let's take some examples. Say the estimated time of arrival, ETA, of Lyft or Uber rides has increased by 3 minutes and you are asked to explain why. There could be many factors contributing to the problem. For instance, you might explore internal factors such as changes to the app's algorithm or external factors such as changes in traffic patterns or increased demand for rides. It is important to approach the investigation systematically and prioritize factors based on their potential impact on the issue. Another example question could be about investigating a 1% drop in daily active users of Slack. Even though it may not be a huge drop, it's essential to figure out the cause of this decline. It could be because of changes to the platform's features or the holiday season, or even increased competition from other messaging apps. Again, having a structured approach is essential to figure out the root cause of the issue. Finally, let's consider a scenario where a referral program in DoorDash isn't generating the expected response rate. To diagnose this problem, you might want to take a look at each step of the referral program funnel to understand why users aren't engaging with it. This could involve looking at the messaging and incentives used to promote the program, how easy it is to refer someone, and what rewards are being offered. So we've gone over the three most common types of questions that you're likely to encounter in a product case interview. And those account for over 60% of questions. So if you're short on time, those are the ones you want to focus on. But let's quickly go over the other 40%. The next type of question is a bit of a catch-all category for product-specific questions that don't really fit into any other categories. These are specific to a product, feature, or company, and they require you to have a deep understanding of the product. Here are some sample questions. How do you evaluate the impact of fake news on Facebook? How do you determine the optimal ratio between company posts and individual posts for LinkedIn feeds. These types of questions can be tricky because they require a deep understanding of the product as well as the industry and market it operates in. To answer them effectively, you need to do your research and understand the underlying factors that impact the product and its users. Another type of question is called improve a product. As you may have guessed, it's about improving a product. These questions aim to evaluate a data scientist's ability to think creatively and come up with solutions to problems. They challenge you to think outside the box and consider how to enhance a product's functionality, user experience, and overall value proposition. Whether it's a software application, a website, or even a service, the possibilities for improvement are endless. Here are some simple questions. How would you improve user engagement on LinkedIn? How would you improve TikTok? And what new features would you add to it? How would you improve what's on your mind posting on Facebook? By asking these questions, interviewers are looking for data scientists who can demonstrate their creativity, problem-solving skills, and attention to detail. They want to see how you approach complex problems and come up with practical solutions that can make a meaningful difference for end users. The next type of question is about strategic thinking. The strategic thinking category is all about evaluating a data scientist's ability to analyze complex scenarios and make informed decisions that have a long-term impact on product or company. These questions require you to consider the bigger picture. Here are some simple questions. Back in 2016, there was no story feature on Instagram. How do you decide whether to launch this feature or not? What should the hourly rate for Instacart shoppers be? These questions are designed to test your ability to identify potential obstacles and opportunities, analyze data, and come up with practical solutions. To excel in this category, it's important to step back from the details and consider the broad implications of your decisions. This requires a deep understanding of market trends, user behavior, and the competitive landscape. You need to evaluate risks and benefits and develop a plan that balances short-term and long-term goals. This can be challenging, but it's an essential skill for any data scientist who wants to make a meaningful impact on a product or a company. Now, the last type of question we are going to cover is what I call estimation. Are you someone who loves to think fast and make quick calculations based on limited information? If so, you might enjoy the estimation questions category, often asked by banks and consulting firms like Capital One, BCG, and Discover. While estimation questions may not be as common in tech companies, they can still be an essential part of the data science interview process for other industries. These questions challenge you to think on your feet and develop a quick estimate based on the information provided. For example, you might be asked to calculate the profit for a credit card partnership based on existing users, revenue, costs, and potential joint marketing campaigns. To ace this type of question, you need to be comfortable with numbers and have a strong grasp of basic arithmetic and financial concepts. You also need to be able to quickly understand the context of the problem and identify the key pieces of information needed to develop an estimate. All right, that's it for today's video on product case interview questions. We identified 7 types of questions that you might encounter during an interview using a data-driven method. By focusing on these question types, you can better prepare yourself for the interview process and increase your chances of success. If you want to take your preparation to the next level, I have a product case interview cheat sheet that you can download for free. It covers all the categories of questions we talked about today, plus some additional ones. Just check out the link in the description below to grab your copy. So go ahead and download the cheat sheet, practice your skills, and get ready to crush that interview. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe for more videos like this. See you soon!